you, it's always you. If I'm ever gonna fall in love, I know it's gonna be you, it's always you. Met a lot of people, but nobody feels like you. So please don't break my heart, don't tear me apart. I know how it starts, trust me, I've been broken before.
Dear guests, a very good evening. We are honored to have you here tonight. My name is David Nyamyonjo.
My name is Susan Kataike.
Son of the late Prudence Isingoma and Mr. Keith Talieva Isingoma of Ruengoma Fort Poto.
My mom is Helen Apollot and my father is Mzee Magino Kafugani.
I studied from Kainj Primary School. Then joined Mpanga Senior Secondary School, and after secondary I joined Makerere University Business School. Did BCom Accounting, and all the subsequent programs have been pursued from the same institution.
I went to St. Peter's Primary School in Zambia, and I went to Toro Girls for my O-level. And my HSA, I studied in Muni Girls in Arua. Then I joined Makerere University Business School. And now I'm working at Clinic Master International as a business development officer.
I first met Susan in the year 2004, somewhere in Glory. It was an evening towards Easter time. I saw this gorgeous lady in a black and white blouse, looking very cute. And the moment I saw her, I immediately felt in love. I had never felt like this before.
I was there one time. I was looking to a shop. I found him standing with his friends in front of their gate. Then I greeted them and I just walked. It was towards Easter then. I heard them speaking in Nyankole, so I also somehow greeted. I don't even know which language. He says I spoke Lutoro, but I don't remember.
Unfortunately, she walked, she went to her place. I didn't know where she was staying. I didn't know I would ever see her again. But something told me after some time to go and sit somewhere and wait for her. I thought she would pass by. I picked my friend, Ainea. We went and sat at a restaurant for the whole day, somewhere in Golori, hoping Susan would pass by. And guess what? Susan came and I stopped her. She looked surprised. But I had to gain the courage to tell her I was feeling. And the conversation started. I couldn't believe she could accept my appointment.
I loved him before he even knew me. But I could not talk. But then, it just happened. I don't even know how.
We went to Silver Springs after some time. Had a cup of tea and we became friends, and that is how our story started.
It's God who brought him, because he didn't even know how I was feeling. I had never said any word to him. I had not even shown any signs, but he just came.
After some time, she accepted to become my girlfriend. It was the best thing, it was the best news that I could get. And in 2007, something happened. We got Daniela, our firstborn. Keith came. And now we have the third one, Ashley. Three bouncing children.
I think God is the one who brought us together.
Susan is a very beautiful lady, as you can all see.
David is an honest man.
Very humorous. very intelligent, welcoming. She's a very organized lady.
He's just himself. He does not like pretense. He's honest, he's kind, and very social.
She can cook. You people, if you've not tasted her food, please, after this wedding, pass by and you taste the food.
He loves everyone. He never wants to hurt anyone. That is him.
She's an open person. If she doesn't like something, she will tell you. And you reconcile there and then. Enjoy her.
He's also so loving. But above all, he's really a very, very social man.
I can find myself laughing with her from morning to morning. And I can't even forget that there's something else I had to do. This is a person you can crack a joke with and she'll understand it immediately. She's that sharp. She loves me. I love her. She has organized me. She's smart. I think you've seen her. I thank God that such a person could become my
almost died when I disappeared for some time without communicating to him. I went to the village. That time I didn't have a phone, and I would only receive calls from some shopkeeper in our trading center if I wanted to talk to him. So he wanted to communicate to me, but he couldn't reach me. Every time he would call, maybe the shop would be locked. He starved himself. He fell sick, he lost weight. And when I would be there at home, the shopkeeper would send someone and call me. When I would go and talk to him, he was like, oh my God, I have been calling since morning. And that's how we used to communicate. When I returned Kampala, I found him really sick in bed. I thought whether he had malaria or what. But just seeing me made him fine. He became happy. That day he started eating. I used to hear the things that people fall sick. Simanya is still. But he was really sick. Even had temperature. But when he saw me, he became fine. That is something that I never forget about him. From that time, I really knew he loved me. Without any strings, I really knew it was true love.
Wow, wow. There are so many moments. But the one I can't forget is that one when she accepted to go with me out. And we went to Silver Springs. Remember, we borrowed my friend's car, Honorable Choma Xavier's Corona. We played music for the whole night in the parking lot. We had fun. I'll never forget that night.
David, I promise to love you, and every day will be a fresh day for us, like it has always been. Every day seems like we've just met. Many people admire us, and I want it to continue until we grow old. I will love you every day like it's a fresh day. Like I promised you last time, my love will be natural and fresh each and every day of our lives. I love you.
All right. What you came for? Don't you wish you came more? Girl, what you playing for? Come on, let me kiss that. Ooh, I know you missed that. What's wrong? Let me fix that. Twist that. Baby, tonight's the night I let you know. Baby, tonight's the night
My name is Friday Thomas. I'm a childhood friend of David Yamyonjo.
George William Yamyonjo Aboli. I knew David since childhood in the late 1970s.
I'm about to meet Omar Kenneth. David Mtowange nwa kumpondera.
I'm a better guy when you're still very here. Salo.
It so happened that we reported for P1 on the same day. And our respective dads knew each other quite very well. And on that day, I vividly remember that we were made to sit next to each other. And as you can imagine, we've been close to each other since that time. I've even lost count of the years.
We grew up together in the same locality. And went to the same school. I was a class or two ahead of him in Kahinja Primary School. So definitely we would interact on a number of times. And in secondary, David was so much interested in mathematics. And I was also a mathematician. So we bonded so much because of that. Not only mathematics, but he was someone who really wanted books.
Amaguru nagata mu besene harimo amaze David nosanga gwijagirira hameza no ngabite David to byama.
We really wanted books and would go to Kahim secondary where we would split some numbers together here and there. And that was our daily life.
What is interesting that came through this crossing of paths. We succeeded in challenging each other academically and otherwise, as you all know.
And he's a man who loved music so much, and I too love music so much. So we had a lot of things that were so common between myself and him. So we listen to music, we buy tapes. It was so, you remember how hard it was getting a tape that time. So we'd go to Blueport, get some tapes, we'd come somewhere where there is a cassette, we'd play. I remember his brother Kenneth had a Contech. So we'd bring those cassettes of ours, we played music the whole day, and that was our way of life.
We used to switch positions in terms of performance. It would either be him coming out first, and myself coming in the close second, or the other way around. And we also got puzzled how that turned out to be, that it became the cycle for all the 7 years.
Ongezi Singoma, doctor, akampeza bana bikubigeza. Omarimo, namba kiona, kya kabo manisi.
But it did not end there. We've remained together from that time.
So
we've carried on those strikes to the present day. David was my best man.
David yugo mwana akakura hano mikono yeyi nkamwegesa home Sunday school akabali mwana arkwata mwegeso rukara mu Bible na arkwata kana kwa nombantu na arsobora kurungi.
David yagonzaga muno kusaba.
Moses wamweta. I'm a brother to Susan.
Hi. My name is Apophis, a sister to Susan.
We grew up with Susan. From childhood, I'm her elder brother.
I got to know Susan and that they were dating with David in 2005. I was in P6. And I stayed with them in my P7 vacation.
For me as a brother, definitely I was happy, because it is the pride of every brother to see a sister finding the love of her life.
Of course, everyone feels good when a sister has someone she loves and she's willing to end up with. Something I can't forget about Susan is that she really loves to party. And she's very outgoing, she's social, and I love the fact that they've always been happy and standing by each other. And I pray they remain like that in this marriage that they're going to enter into by God's grace. And I pray that they live together forever and they give birth to more beautiful and handsome kids. All the best.
David, you know I call him Ayoyo.
David bamukaguzaga cyane mutibarari yawe ni wowe agamba Ayoyo.
And Susan, she's a charming lady. She's very free. She's so welcoming. And to me, I think I would be comfortable. I wouldn't hesitate so comfortably say David is a lucky person to have a woman like Susan as a wife. And I'm just excited that a time like this is coming when they are tying the knot.
Omkwano Susan, thank you very much for accepting to be my wife. You are the best thing that has happened to me. I couldn't have got a better woman than you. Thank you very much, thank you very much. I promise to love you forever.